Welcome back everyone, I'm Craven and this is Trails the Third. We are back at the local for our next and final location we have unlocked in this area, which is, I think, Grimsoul Fortress. The location where all the final testing is being done for the braces that are being trained here. So the only thing we can do is go and explore it. Because just like with the forest, I wonder how much of it is actually the same. Do we also need different key cards to proceed? And of course, who, if any, will we find in here? Whose stone can we unlock? Now this is one fancy looking training facility. It is crazy complicated inside too. Estelle and I had a blast trying to get through it when we were here. Especially the rooms where it's pitch black. Those were just awesome. Not... I remember having my fair share of trouble with these two. I can't wait to see what kind of traps we bump into inside then. Anyway, as far as I can tell, this should be our final ordeal on this plane, so let's get this done. Right. So there are two things we can possibly encounter here. That's another grimoire looking like one of our gnome bracer friends, which then of course gives us a stone. Or there's gonna be another demon at the end of it. Okay, this is already very different, the fact that there is no side door for us to get into. Alright, so basically an entire new area for us to explore, so let's do it. Spiral Grill. Hey again, wait, where's that guy you were here with before? And of course, healing, as long as I don't forget it, instantly use it. That's how we don't forget to learn the recipes. Of course, just like with the third, I want to see if I can get all the recipes. And after that, we can decide whether or not to try and remake every single one of them. There's a slot to insert a card key. Some kind of ID seems to be required. Same principle, but a totally different look and feel to the place. Daryl Balm. There's no greater void than one between your ears. Alright, bit crude, but I can't deny that's true. Ooh, that looks a little bit like a gremlin. A werebat. Alternate ways to obstruct foes, then takes their HP and EP. Pretty strong to put two. But in all honesty, I have gotten used to a little bit with the damage Shira did when she was younger. And do have to say that seeing her hair when she was younger, the new haircut is really growing on me, I have to be honest with that. Man, these werebats are actually quite strong. Yeah, you go for the rat. Just in case you deathblow it. There is one thing I do want to check. I want to see if we have Josette. Yeah, we do. She's still up in the corner as our remote ability. So that support role is still active. Nice. I wonder if there's going to be other people with the same kind of support role as well, like others with drop rates increased. And now that Joshua is on 200 again, now we can abuse it once more. Yeah, there's nothing better than giving everyone a bit of an evil stare. So is it gonna be like the same amount of levels we had originally here? I think it was three levels we needed to go through in order to get to Kurt. Will it be here as well that we need to find 3 levels of key cards? I'm pretty sure we need to be at the end location where the key cards is, isn't it? Also, one of the reasons why I am just blasting our way forward, because I think we will be back. Alright, power towards the door, I bet. But that doesn't mean we might still need a key card. And there is still one way we haven't gotten to yet. Having said that, there's a chance that there are enemy encounters that actually drop the ID, so until we've got one, we have to assume that's the case. This punishment. Let's end this. Yeah, if we can play around between Kevin and Joshua, then in between they can both just raise their CP back to normal levels. Oh yeah! Look at that line. Doesn't matter how much it actually is, the fact that there's a nice big old line of Sephiroth there, it just looks beautiful. Another barrier. Would it have worked without the power on? I wonder. Could be that we just walked exactly in the direction we needed to. ID card. We tell you to have a barrel of fun, but come on. We wouldn't call them treasure barrels. Which is technically true. Alright. Well, maybe you can join in on the fun as well. It's just so easy to just hit multiple enemies at once. This is one of the reasons why I love having Tita in our party. Because it doesn't need more or special skills in order to attack an entire list of enemies. I didn't have to make a choice whether or not to use it. I just did. Yeah, she will definitely be coming back into the party at some point. First gate open. Shira, is it just me or is this place layout way different from the real version? You thought the same too, huh? Completely different how? Well, the placement of the rooms and the corridors, everything. I suppose it's possible that it was remodeled after Annalise used it. Well, the sealed area layout was completely different from the real one too. I wouldn't be the first time this had happened. Probably something our foes did intentionally too. Exactly. We'll have to be very careful. Well, let's be honest, making it a little bit different also makes it a little bit more interesting. Okay. Is it just to teach us how it works? Probably. Juggernaut. I should move to a palace. That way I could be a court jester. Yeah. Alright, I can accept that pun. Alright, from 1416 to 1616. So yeah, definitely time to get an upgrade. Because we skipped the last one. Because of the down side of the stats. Chicken is that? Birdman. Beastman with a bird's head that causes blind confusion and drains a CP. Alright, you just got a ticket to be punished. Let's end this. But basically, I don't mind the bats because HP, EP, you can easily get that back. C EP, however, that's a different story, so let's dump all over the Birdman. We can. We are hitting it way out of the park. Alright. Yeah, might need to use a little bit of arts to damage it a bit more. Yeah, even with a feather would have destroyed it now. I think a normal attack is more than sufficient.
<Not bad.
laughs> Well, as long as they don't steal our Sepith, they can do whatever they want. Ah, okay, so there's just one switch, and I assume it works for all the bridges in the entire facility. So later on, when there's multiple bridges in one screen, you need to definitely play around with it. Why run away? Why? I always do that. Really, it's been three games and I still run away from them. Oh well, it's fine. Might as well use magic against those. Yeah, you can take care of the rat first, so we can fully focus on the bird. So got another Birdman there, no chest, so there's no need for us to get in that corner. But there were two ways for us to get there. I'm trying to find a way that's not the way forward, if you understand what I mean. Because if we go against the wrong way, we can always go back and go the right way. So it just means that we have a less chance of missing anything. That's why I like ID card doors, because once you find the ID, you know where to beat to continue on. So you can just go every other direction and just have a look around to not go there. Ah, we'll be fine. So there are two ways. Zeron powder. Back for more items? What am I? A shop to you? So we could have gone here. Now the question which way is the right one? Or will they all lead to the same location, is the question, isn't it? With the red one, we wouldn't be able to go across. Very intriguing. No, not yet. I want to check this location first. We can change this to red, but it will block off our way to get back here in order to check what's here. So this could be a way back. Or can we just go all the way here, flip the switch, and let's go back? We can, can't we? Now that we know what the effect of that is, we can use it to our advantage. There's not an instant card, some kind of ID must be needed. Okay, so now we know where we need to be to continue on. We just need to find a power source and an ID. Alright, good. So I'm just gonna put everything back again. Because having this one on red doesn't do anything for me to get to the ID card. No, let's check the other side first. Because there might be just a chest. It is just a chest. There's just no way to get there. Oh, that's fine. Around. Ooh, not a preemptive. Oh well, we tried.
Let's end this.
No, this is too easy. I cannot not do it. Destroying two enemies delaying another. Priceless. We haven't seen any of his CP drain attacks, have we? Not that I actually need to see it. I believe the rumors. Also, was it the Heavenly Gaze or so we got in Shiro's memory? I gave it instead of the Information Quartz to Joshua. Which will be probably be given back to Reese once she rejoins the party as a fixed member. Because information? Definitely something you want to have in there. ID card 2. Do we actually want this? Nope. Yeah, we just need to make the same way back, I guess. Ah, didn't even see us. I know, don't say it. I'm here, I can see it. Right, that means we have to go back and put it back on red so we can get to the door. And apparently this time we don't need to power it, so the powering was for that other partition to open up. Good to know, at least we know what to expect from it. Nothing to say? Yeah. We know it's different. We don't need to keep on saying it. I think it was the right show to bring Shira and Lace with us, because they know the facility, so they are the people that could give those remarks to us. Uh-oh. We don't have that, right? We don't have the goggles. Not yet, at least. Because I'm pretty sure there's gonna be a side pass somewhere, isn't it? Or an enemy. I'm not even allowed to attack them? How cruel. Oh well, then I'll be back once I find some night goggles. Okay, very intriguing. The door can be opened as no orbital energy is flowing to it. So we need to find our way through a maze of boxes. Can you give us some goggles instead? Thank you. This is not what it looks like. Oh, you know who I'm gonna give it to. The one who fights best in the dark. Yeah, you will have your anti-death blow back as soon as you can. Alright, did not see that. Can they attack now that we have someone who can actually do something? Technically, yes, but let's use some arts. Because chances of those hitting are a little bit higher. Do we want... Well, there's still a chance of hitting, right? Even though if it's very low. Who knows, maybe when we power everything up, the lights will turn back on as well.
Oh, are we done already?
Thank you! Just like I wanted. There's one thing I want to do. I want to check if there is another room to the side. No, it is not. Might as well keep it on for the time being. Ah, beautiful sound. The sound of maxing out CPs. No! Oh, that's not what I aimed for. I do hope that we do get an indicator when we're almost at the end, like a monument stone that we can recover and save. Cause then I know I can get rid of the night goggles. Cause it would be very cruel to let us fight against a boss in the dark with one night goggles. Preemptive strike in the dark. At this point, you wish you had more area on your ascension. I'm just going by the assumption that we are going to be recovered before we hit the boss area. And besides, this change in magic is always nice. And with Aerial, you know you're not attacking the enemy, just attacking the ground. So even if you do defeat the enemy, it doesn't change anything. They still will be hit, all of them. Well, you can still not hit them. One. Oh, Annalise, you really do suck as a magic user, don't you? Oh well. To each their own forte, I guess. Aiming for actually. This is a pretty big room. I'm guessing we're aiming for another power station. Your luscious look of locks of hair are nothing compared to my lovely locks of steel. Well, they both have their own appeal. I would say locks of steel more curb appeal than anything else. Moon glasses. I'm going to start to charging at this rate. Yep. Because not everybody opens up like you do. No. Night goggles. Moon glasses. Ah, yes, we have one. I think Charizard is actually wearing one of those. Thank you very much. Yeah, with night goggles you're not chasing markings on the floor anymore. I think that is where we came in. Here we would have learned there is no power. This door will not open. Making a fast. Ooh, what the hell? Okay, that caught me a little bit off guard. Yeah, leave the red enemies just in case we need some extra. Birdman, however, you can go down. Let's end this. Damn, here I was thinking that we are coming towards the end. That was my genuine thought. Yeah, I don't think they will stay in place, to be honest. Oh well. All go for Annalise. That's not Annalise. Beautiful critical. Thank you. No. Maybe. Yeah, she can do it.
I am invincible. Or am I?
Right, a restorative and a shop. So I'm guessing going back is just for some extra chests? which you don't have to worry about. We are definitely gonna go back for it, don't worry. Okay, no goggles, meaning if there's no goggles for sale, they will not put a boss in a dark room. So Joshua, you can take those off. And where is your... Oh, it wasn't the lunar seal we were wearing. A skull pendant. The worst thing they could do to us. Death. Alright. If that's the case, we're just gonna pick up the chest and then we're gonna move on forward to potentially see what kind of boss we have to fight. So like I said, it could be a grimoire, one of our other friends, or an actual demon, the one we usually see when we have to cross seals. Or it's just something that splits in two. When to finish this location, we get a grimoire, and after that we go to a location waiting us with a demon of Gehenna that we need to defeat. New one is a possibility. Silver earring. I thought we could be friends. You have thought wrong. That doesn't matter, but we're gonna heal ourselves at the stone anyway. As long as we don't die while walking through it, I think we should be fine. Alright, let's see what that plus thing is doing. It prevents poison and gives us a lot of extra defense with us. Is someone wearing it in our party? No. You know what? I think I'm gonna leave it as it is. Come on. With this party, we should be more than capable of defeating whatever is thrown at us. Come on. Let's do this. We have enough healing items, enough attack power. We can do this. Looks like a grimoire. A git. Ooh. Tita will be happy. A git. Crap. We're up against a git this time. Well, well. This looks like it's going to be a fight to remember. This fight isn't going to be the easiest, but it's not anything we can't handle. Let's do this, guys! Right! Having said that, let's see what we're dealing with first. A female beast? One of the hell's jailers. With the head of an ox becomes mad with anger at enough damage. 24,000? And more of the same. Wield a giant blade effortlessly to mow down its enemies. Yeah, basically. Anything we like to do? That's the thing with all of this, it just takes too much time. Time I do not have. Yes. Okay, let's with him at least. So just do it then. Aim for the one person I want to have it at least. Alright, he has about 200. We know Deathblow occasionally works on the Grimoire as well. And I think we might want to get rid of a git first so it doesn't do any S-craft on its own, right? And who gives a crap about extra stats? That's beautiful. Alright, cause what we can do. Get a little bit of extra advantage to ourselves. Cell support. Area M attack gathers enemies of blade. Alright, so we're gonna go straight into the S crop, we might as well. But that would take care of the initial form of a git, right? And I think maybe we should save Cerizard's and Kevin's CP for whatever is potentially next after this. That we've taken care of the first form, let's go after the female beasts. or however I need to pronounce it. Hit him hard.
Let's end this. hold in my hand the chalice of heaven. May its holiest of lights act as our shield.
Grail spear!
Is it going to happen this time? A version without the fight crashing? Or have I doomed myself by saying it out loud right now? Because in all my attempts, it always crashes at a move that a git does, but it doesn't necessarily say anything, of course. Okay, it might not have been necessary, but doesn't matter. Let's see. Art. No, lowering defense won't be a thing, right? I think I just need to attack one of them. Preferably the weaker one. Would it be enough? Well, might as well just try. Yeah, and for those who haven't noticed it or don't know about it, there is a glitch in this part of the game that in the fight against Agit here, the game crashes, and it crashes a lot. Don't know why, but for me at least, it happened every time Agit did a certain move. I couldn't pick up which move it was, but every once in a while, during a fight, it just crashes and the entire game collapses. So far, I'm still alive. So let's see if we can keep it that way until after we get rewarded for this. And I can save it. Alright. Come on, it's a few more measly hits. And this nightmare will be over. And that's also the main reason why I've been quiet during most of that fight. Action 3 and Soldier Tubby. Ceiling Stone. Phew, well, that's that. For the love of Ayos, though, he's a damn tank. Well, he certainly is, though I wouldn't expect any less. Still, now we should be able to have him fighting on our side. I'm sure Tito will be stoked to hear about this. Let's go back and tell her. Well, the main thing I want to do is one for going back is restoring everything, because I'm pretty sure once we get through that door, in order to officially crush this plane down, I'm pretty sure we need to fight a demon. But that, and including the unsealing of Agit, I think I'm gonna keep that for the next episode. That way, surprise, surprise, what if it isn't him? Even though we're pretty sure it is. We're gonna open up the stone, get done with this plane, going to the fifth, and I think we have three planes left to get towards that ending, and of course many, many doors we still have in between to open up for story bits. But that's gonna be next time. Until then, I wish you all a great night, morning, day, wherever you are. And if you're still here, don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe, and make sure to be back next time as we try to finish off the fourth plane. Bye bye.